Hello, welcome. Thank you for joining us today. I am the founder and managing director at Data Crossroads. We provide training and consulting services in the area of data management. My areas of expertise are data management maturity assessment, setting up data management frameworks, and establishing data lineage business cases. Today we will discuss the mapping between three leading industry guides. In this presentation, we will focus on three key questions. First, we review the industry guides we are going to compare and map. The second question is, why do we need such a mapping? The last and the most crucial question is, how to map them? In this presentation, I will compare two leading data management industry guides and one enterprise architecture guide. The first one is the Data Management Body of Knowledge by the DAMA International, second version. I will use the abbreviation DAMA DM book throughout the presentation. The second is the Data Management Capability Assessment Model by the Enterprise Data Management Council. I will use the abbreviation DECAM. I will also use the TOGAF 9.2 standard, which is the leading enterprise architecture framework. Enterprise architecture and data management have several matching building blocks. These are business data and application architecture. I have included TOGAF into consideration because of this matching. The orange model is the data management implementation framework. The orange model is the development of Data Crossroads. I use the key diagrams of these models to compare the three industry guides that I have just mentioned. DAMA DM Book and DECAM are leading data management industry guides. A couple of months ago, I placed several polls on LinkedIn. The first poll has focused on the usage of industry guides for the implementation of data management. The second has investigated the use of data management maturity models. In each of these polls, I have added DAMA DM Book and DECAM as optional answers. As you can see, DAMA DM Book is a champion in the results of both polls. DECAM has become the second leading industry framework. DECAM statistics is an interesting result. Initially, DECAM has targeted only financial institutions. It seems that DECAM has become a more generic framework. The comparison of different industry guides is a challenging exercise. One of the reasons is that these frameworks have different viewpoints on data management and its content. The definition of data management and data governance differs significantly in a different context and in different models. I use several key diagrams of the orange model of data management to perform this comparison. Let's start with the first diagram. It demonstrates the concept map of data management. This concept map includes the high-level capabilities of data management. Data resources or assets are the key subjects of data management. Data assets have quality. Enterprise architecture describes and designs data assets. Information technology enables the life cycle of data assets. Security mitigates risk associated with the usage of information technology and data assets. Data management framework or data governance designs and implements rules and roles. This diagram doesn't expose the dynamic character of data. For that, I will use the second diagram of the orange model. Everything starts with a business and its model. A company delivers a value to its customers. You can use different methods to describe the business model. Here, you can see Porter's model. You can also use the business canvas model or the business capabilities models, whichever you like. The orange model defines data management as a business capability. I have used the business capability model by the Open Group. A business capability is the ability of a company to reach some goals or deliver outcomes. The same goes for data management. Data management designs and implements data chains. Data chains transform data into information. A set of data management sub-capabilities enables the functioning of data chains. Data management framework, data quality are examples of such capabilities. Each company should identify its scope of data management and the set of required capabilities. Each data management sub-capability plays a particular role at some steps of data chain. For example, data modeling capability delivers data requirements and data models. This capability is required at two stages of the data chain. Four dimensions describe each sub-capability. Role, process, data, and tool are the key dimensions. So, let me summarize the three key points of this diagram. First, data management is a business capability. It consists of a set of sub-capabilities. These sub-capabilities enable the designing and functioning of data chains. Four dimensions enable each sub-capability. Now let's move to the comparison of industry guides. Now we will investigate the differences and commonalities between the content and building blocks of the three guides. As you may see, I have used the last diagram to compare these models. I have plotted the key business blocks of DAMA, DECAM and TOGAF to the orange model diagram. A blue circle represents DAMA, the yellow one is for DECAM and green for TOGAF. Even visually, you see pretty significant differences between these guides. For example, business architecture is present in DECAM and TOGAF models. Data modeling and design is only a building block of the DAMA model. Later on, I will demonstrate that both DECAM and TOGAF consider data modeling artifacts as a part of data architecture, and so on. This picture leads to the following conclusion. DAMA and DECAM have different views on data management. Let's briefly summarize the fundamental differences between DAMA and DECAM data management models. DAMA and DECAM use different building blocks to describe data management. DAMA uses knowledge areas. DECAM operates with a set of components, capabilities, sub-capabilities, and so on. I didn't manage to find the precise definition of these building blocks neither for DAMA nor for DECAM models. DAMA has 11 knowledge areas, DECAM uses 8 components, 36 capabilities, and so on. Now we have finished the high-level comparison. The second topic of our presentation is why do we need to map different models? I can mention two apparent reasons. The first one is the alignment of terminology within the data management community. Assume two data management professionals discuss data governance challenges. One uses the DAMA model, another applies the DECAM model. If they don't align the definition of data governance beforehand, it will be Babylon's talk. The second reason is the maturity assessment. Assume a company uses the DAMA model to implement data management. Then they decide to use DECAM or some other maturity models to assess the maturity level. The key requirement to perform such an assessment is to map and align data management and data management maturity models. You can come up with some other reasons. Now we can focus on the main goal of this presentation, which is to demonstrate the mapping between three leading industry guides. First, I will share with you the key assumptions I have put in this mapping. Then, I will demonstrate the high-level mapping between various building blocks. Next, I will continue this detailed explanation of the mapping of separate business blocks. And I will end up the presentation with a comparison of the maturity assessment approaches of DAMA and DECAM. Now I want to explain assumptions that I have used to map models. One of the key challenges in mapping different models is to find comparable elements. These elements should be similar by nature and be at the same level of abstraction. After careful consideration, I have chosen the following elements: knowledge areas deliverables from the DAMA DECAM book, deliverables from TOGAF, and adjusted sub-capabilities from DECAM. The second assumption is about the scope of the comparison. I have taken only building blocks that are similar for at least two frameworks. The third assumption is the terminology that I use. From now on, I use the term capability to substitute and align knowledge area by Dhamma, component and sub-capability by Dikam, and the phases by the Togav. First, we will take a look at the scope and high-level mapping between capabilities from different models. You see the list of capabilities that I am going to map. Let us take a look at the intersections. Initially, we will take a look at Dhamma and Dikam. Data governance from Dhamma intersects data management strategy, program, and funding and data governance. Data quality corresponds to data quality. And data ethics in Dhamma corresponds to data governance and Dikam. Dikam capabilities intersect the following capabilities from Togav: business and data architecture from Dikam intersects the data architecture in Togav. And data and technology architecture with application and technology architecture in Togav. All three guides cross each other with the following capabilities: data modeling and design and data architecture from the Dhamma can be mapped to data governance and business and data architecture from Dikam and with data architecture in Togav. It's complicated, isn't it? Now we can move into the comparison of each of these combinations. This slide demonstrates the mapping between data governance capability from Dhamma and data management strategy, business case, program, and funding model from Dikam. You see that some deliverables of Dhamma data governance correspond to deliverables to these Dikam capabilities. The key difference is that data governance from Dhamma partly focuses on data management deliverables such as strategy and roadmap, partly on data governance like data governance scorecard, website, etc. At the same time, two indicated capabilities of Dikam only focus on data management. In this slide, we investigate relationships between the data governance of two guides, Dhamma DMBOK and Dikam. Remarkable, these two capabilities don't have much in common. Data governance policies, roles, and processes are similar. So I can assume that the operating framework from Dhamma corresponds to the data governance organizational structure from Dikam. But this assumption can be wrong. So as you see, not many matches exist. The data quality capabilities of both frameworks have a lot of similarities. For example, strategy, processes, roles. There are also some minor differences. For example, the Q capability from Dikam includes data quality rules. Dhamma doesn't include them in the list of deliverables. At the same time, Dhamma includes service level agreements, DQ policies, and standards as a part of DQ capability. Data ethics is not a part of the Dhamma wheel. Still, the Dhamma DMBOK covers this topic. This topic has become important during the last few years. Dikam includes data ethics into data governance capability. The most striking result of the analysis is that there is no intersection between Dhamma and Dikam viewpoints on data ethics. Now we will investigate the similar capabilities between Dikam and Togav. The first group is the business and data architecture from Dikam and business architecture from Togav. It's worth mentioning that Dikam combines business and data architecture in one capability. Togav recognizes these two capabilities separately. Therefore, in this slide, I compare only business architecture deliverables. As you see, I have found only one possible match between the deliverables of these two frameworks. This is business data requirements versus business data model. I have concluded the following. Dikam doesn't actually cover the business architecture capability. Instead, it focuses only on the alignment between business and data architecture. This alignment leads to the identification of business requirements. The CAP also requests the development of business architecture processes. On the contrary, TOGAF concentrates on the actual deliverables of business architecture. The business architecture processes are not part of the TOGAF deliverables. The subsequent mapping is the data and technology architecture of DECAM versus application and technology architecture in TOGAF. For unknown reasons, DECAM didn't include application architecture in the list of its capabilities. DECAM defines some capabilities or deliverables that relate to technology architecture. These two guides demonstrate different approaches than the approaches taken towards business architecture. For business architecture, DECAM considered only the relationships between data and business architecture. The capabilities of technology architecture directly relate to the technology architecture itself. The mapping on this slide demonstrates this statement. We have finalized the comparison between DECAM and TOGAF. Now we will pay attention to the most complex and challenging mapping. We will map two capabilities from DAMA, data modeling and design and data architecture, this data architecture from TOGAF, and data governance and data architecture from DECAM. I have split the analysis in two parts. The first, which I demonstrate at this slide, relates to data modeling related deliverables. The second part will describe data architecture deliverables. On this slide, you can see the mapping between data modeling deliverables. The relationships are somewhat complicated. Some remarkable differences are: different capabilities identify data models as their deliverables. In DAMA Dame book, it's data modeling in design. TOGAF specifies data models as the outcome of data architecture. For some reasons, DECAM put data models in business in data architecture. DAMA Dame book identifies three types of data models: conceptual, logical, and physical. In TOGAF, I found only references to business and logical data models. DECAM in data governance speaks about data models in general. For some reasons, data domains appear in both the data governance and the business and data architecture sections of DECAM. Business definitions are also a notable point. DAMA Dame book includes these deliverables in data governance, while DECAM into business and data architecture. Now it's time to look at the deliverables of data architecture, except for data models. You can see the results on this slide. I can make only one conclusion. The vision of the deliverables of data architecture differs greatly in three industry frameworks. Isn't it remarkable? Three leading industry frameworks, DAMA, DECAM, and TOGAF, differ significantly in their viewpoints of data management. You can find such differences at higher and lower levels of abstractions. The building blocks have different nature, knowledge area in DAMA, components and sub-capabilities in DECAM, and phases in the architecture development method TOGAF. At the high level of abstraction, we identify differences in the composition of building blocks. At the lower level of abstractions, such as deliverables and sub-capabilities, the content of building blocks differs greatly. The final topic in my presentation is the comparison of maturity assessment approaches. Four components constitute a data management maturity model. The first is the model's building blocks. We have already analyzed the building blocks of DAMA and DECAM. The second is the number of maturity levels. We see that the DAMA and DECAM have six levels of maturity, but they differ significantly by names and content. We will discuss it in the next slide. The third component is the assessment criteria. DAMA uses 5 dimensions that describe each knowledge area. I assume that assessment of the maturity should be done at the level of these dimensions. However, the methodology to perform such an assessment remains unclear. It looks like that DICOM assesses the maturity at the level of sub-capabilities. Both models haven't disclosed the method to aggregate the assessment from the lower abstraction level to the higher one. You can see the comparison between the number, names, and content of maturity levels on the slide. I have put all characteristics in a table format to ease the comparison. The names are quite different. The levels are not comparable. For example, the initial ad hoc level by DAMA is level 1, while DICOM put the ad hoc level to the level 0, non-initiated. It means that a company with the ad hoc status of data management activities will fall into different maturity levels depending on the chosen framework. As I said before, the method to aggregate the maturity levels of each sub-capability at the higher level of abstraction remains a mystery for both models. After the brief analysis, we can conclude the following. The approaches to measuring data management maturity by DAMA and DICOM differ to a great extent. The differences can be found in the number and content of building blocks of the models, assessment criteria, methods to describe the maturity levels. The method to aggregate the maturity levels to assess a company's overall maturity is unclear for both frameworks. This is the end of this presentation. I hope I have managed to give you an idea about the challenges associated with mapping between different data management models. More materials you can find at my site. Should you still have questions, please reach out to me through our website datacrossroads.nl or connect with me on LinkedIn. You can also schedule a free 30-minute consultation with me. If you have any feedback, please leave it in the comments section below this video. Thank you for joining me today.